Hi, I'm Albert, and we're here to talk about Azure Network Security. Hi, Sinead.
Hi there, Albert.
Yeah. Tell us, what are some of the Azure Network Security services that our audience should know about?
The first service is Azure Firewall, and it's a firewall as a service. And what it does is it's a cloud-native service first.
Right.
And it's auto-scalable, highly available, redundant, and it enables customers to centrally govern all their traffic flows in the environment. And customers might say, well, why do you need it? It also works across subscription and across VNets.
Yeah.
And so it's sort of a network firewall versus NSG, which are more, you know, sort of think of it as more host-based or VNet-based. And so it works in orchestration with it.
Right. And I also heard that there's this thing called the Azure Web Application Firewall. Can you tell us more about that?
Yeah, so WAF is different. So WAF is, the primary goal for WAF is to protect inbound traffic into Azure over HTTP.
Right.
And it's all about protecting the application.
Yes.
And so typically a web app might be open to the internet or open to a set of people, and you don't know if they're all have good intentions or if they've been compromised. And so it's really about protecting the application.
Right.
Whereas Azure Firewall plays a sort of different role. Its role is to sort of lock down the environment and make sure there's good access control between the resources.
Right.
And so they typically get deployed side by side.
And I guess Azure Firewall also protects network from inbound and outbound as well.
Yeah, correct. Right. Correct. And many customers will use it either north-south or they will use it east-west as well. So it also plays a pretty important role in your network segmentation strategy.
Right. So distributed denial of service has been going up, you know, and all these attacks has been increasing on a year-to-year basis. And so can you tell us more how Azure can help protect that?
Yeah, natively Azure provides DDoS protection for the region and for the environment. But we also have a service that's specifically tuned to your application. So it's tuned to your application patterns.
Right.
And so that's your DDoS service. And this would often be used anytime you have a public IP in Azure, then it's a good idea to have DDoS protection in it.
Right. And do they use all these three services in combination or they use in separately?
Typically, as part of your application protection story, you would have an application delivery, you'd have WAF and DDoS. And so they're a nice combination together.
Yes.
And then if you're looking at sort of your network segmentation, you'd use a combination of software-defined networking and you'll use Azure Firewall.
And then if
for Azure Firewall, if it is a public IP, then you will also use DDoS with it as well. So actually, you will often combine them depending on the use cases.
I see. So it does work with the software-defined network. Out of the box.
Absolutely. So software-defined networking plays a critical role of how do you construct your network topology in the cloud.
Right, right.
So you might have VNets, and then you might have a hub and spoke. You embrace a hub and spoke model where maybe all the devs are working in the spokes, and then you have central IT who is managing a shared service environment where all the traffic will flow there.
Right.
And similarly, you'll have to, if you want to get traffic from on-premises, you'll use something like virtual WAN or Express Route. To allow traffic to flow into your environment. So it really works in combination. It's sort of deployed as part of your network architecture.
Right. So I guess the software-defined network is where they help with the content delivery, micro-segmentation, and also distribution of all the network traffics, right?
Yeah. It's sort of how do you get your traffic to flow
and
let the who's allowed connect kind of to who enable the flows, and then you add the network security then to really lock down the environment.
Okay. So where and how do partners play in this picture?
Partners are critical. First of all, we have a really large set of partners and all of their services are available in the marketplace.
Right.
And so many customers will come to us and say, well, we've already decided this is who we work with, this is who we trust, this is what procurement has approved, and so those solutions. But then we have a whole set of partners who have actually augmented or extended our capabilities. As an example, in Azure Firewall, Tuffin and AlgoSec and Barracuda have done central management on top of the firewall as an example. So many partners do that. And and then we're always working with them pretty closely because we do think that with integration, customers can get a better defense in depth story all up.
That's great. Yeah, we're definitely seeing a lot of partners and a lot of our customers who are using some of our partner solution where they already have decided they use it, they trust it, and they also have the skills to manage some of these resources, right? So definitely, I think partners are critical to Azure.
Yeah.
So thank you, Sinead. So we have more videos to come. So feel free to check them out and stay tuned.